Glory be to God forever and ever. I welcome you into this year as I say Happy New Year, Happy Year 2019. God bless you. All very good. Okay, so I welcome you as I said to you that I will be unveiling the things that will be happening this year, what will take place this year, the prophecy, what you should expect this year. According to what I hear from God, what God said to me, what I hear clearly from Him, what will be happening in Nigeria, in Europe, in America, in all Africa, in Asia, all over the world. This is worldwide prophecy, the prophecy, global prophecy. So I will also unveil to you, especially for Nigeria. This is generally, but I will still tell you what will be happening in Nigeria this year. All right, so I will tell you that this year, 2019, is a beautiful year for God's children, for God's people. It's a beautiful year. It's our year of God's goodness. Our year of God's goodness. And also, it's also a year, it's a bad year for the bad people, for the wicked people. I can't know what God said to me. God said it's our year of goodness, God's goodness. 2019, our year of God's goodness, our year of God's goodness. I will be taking you to the scripture one by one for you to hear. I'm going to give you five prophecies, just five. Write it down, please write it down, five. And know if God is God, if God is still with man. I say to you, it's not a gambling, because the word of Bible says forever, O Lord, your word is settled in heaven. It's not gambling, you know. It's the word of God is accurate. Any prophecy that you receive that you did not see from the word of God, that the preacher or the pastor or the bishop or the man of God did not tell you where God spoke to them, where God speaks to them in His word, throw it away. It's a trash. Every prophecy must be seen in the word of God, and every dream you dream, you must see it in the word of God, or else throw it away, because many things speaks in them of the spirit. The devil speaks. The devil can speak to you. Yourself can speak to you. God can speak to you. The devil can speak. No? So there are many voices. That's why you must be very, very careful to know the one that speaks to you, the one that you hear. Some pastors, they say, it's predicting. What kind of predicting? No, predicting. It's never in the kind of God. Prophecy is just telling God's children what will happen, or what's happening now, or what's going to happen tomorrow, or what happened in the past. This is all about prophecy, and everything is in the word of God. And our God is a God of the past, a God of the present, and a God of future. So anything that you hear that any man is trying to prophesy to you that he did not see clearly in the word of God, throw it away. Either it comes from that person's self, or it comes from the devil, or it comes from his own imaginations or thinking or gambling. Now, I don't want to take your time because of I will be telling you what will happen this year by the grace of God. Listen just now as we move on. I'm reading to you now. The first thing that will happen this year, number one, is found in the book of Proverbs chapter 12. Proverbs chapter 12, verse 21. What will happen this year? No grave trouble will overtake the righteous. No grave trouble will overtake the righteous, but the wicked shall be filled with evil. Number one thing that you will see, that you will experience this year, is everything good will be happening to God's children. Everything good. If you are truly a child of God, everything good will be happening to you this year. Everything good will be happening to you this year. If you are truly a child of God. But the wicked, who are the wicked? People that is lying with the name of God, using His name to steal, to kill, all the people using women's undies as we do as in Africa, doing money ritual, call themselves Yahoo Yahoo. All the thieves, all the criminals, whether you are lying with the Bible or you are not lying with the Bible, but so far you are addicted, you are soaked in evil and wickedness. God said that evil is soaking you now, because this year don't want to see anything look like evil. This year is all about, you want to see good, you want to see everywhere filled with the glory of God, filled with righteousness, filled with truth, filled with good, because our God is good. Our God is good. So he doesn't want to see anything that look like deathness. Anything that look like deathness, anything that look like fraud, anything that look like criminals, political criminals, church criminals, and evil we are seeing in the name of Jesus and the Bible and church. All these are the evil, the wicked people. You know, when I talk about, let me just make it short. Wickedness, evil. This year, any man or any woman that is wicked and evil, evil will soak that person. Evil will soak that life. Evil will soak that family. Evil will soak that nation. To as men that love evil and the wickedness, evil will soak them. But to as men that love truth, love righteousness, love good, and love our God, because our God is the only one that is good. God is good. God is all about love. God is all about good. God is all about justice. God is all about equity. God is all about righteousness. So our God is good. And all his children, he has promised this year that you will not cry. No evil will happen to you. No evil will come upon you or your family or your business or anything that concerns you. But the wicked shall be filled with evil. No grave trouble. You know what's called grave? Grave trouble is hellish life, pains and agony and crying and and being in torment. God has promised you life free of torment, life free of grave trouble. No grave trouble will overtake the righteous. The righteous means the people that love good people. No grave trouble. I say to you, this year, 5 things that I'll give to you, watch it out. No grave trouble will overtake the righteous, but the wicked shall be filled with evil. So number one is that no evil will happen to a true child of God. Good will surround you. Good in the morning, good in the afternoon, and good in the night. But the evil, the wicked people will be soaked with evil, calamity, tragedy. All manner of evil will soak the wicked and evil people. So it is taken from the book of Proverbs chapter 12, verse 21. Number one prophecy. We move on now to number two. Number two, I'm taking it to number two now. Ezekiel, number two. The book of Ezekiel is taken from the book of Ezekiel. Ezekiel chapter 21. Ezekiel chapter 21 is from where number 2 is taken from. I read from verse 1. And the word of the Lord came to me, saying, Son of man, set your face towards Jerusalem, church, preach against the holy places, and prophesy against the land of Israel, and say to the land of Israel, thus saith the Lord, behold, I am against you, and I will draw my sword out of its sheath, and cut off both righteous and wicked from you. Because I will cut off both righteous and wicked from you, therefore my sword shall go out of its sheath against all flesh from south to north, that all flesh may know that I, the Lord, have drawn my sword out of its sheath. It shall not return anymore. Sigh, therefore, son of man, with a bitter heart, and sigh with bitterness before their eyes. And it shall be when they say to you, why are you sighing, that you shall answer, because of the news I have heard. Because of the news, when it comes, every heart will melt, all hands will be feeble, every spirit will faint, and all knees will be weak as water. Behold, it is coming and shall be brought to pass, says the Lord God. Again, the word of the Lord came to me, saying, Son of man, prophesy and say, thus said the Lord, say, a sword is sharpened and also polished. sharpened to make a dreadful slaughter, polished to flash like lightning. Should we then make mad? It despises the scepter of my son, as it does all wood, and he has given it to be polished, that it may be handled. This sword is sharpened, and it is polished, to be given into the hand of the slayer. Cry and wail, son of man, for it will be against my people. It will be against my people, against all the prince of Israel, against God's people, that is called itself God's children, and against their pastors. Cry and wail, son of man, for it will be against my people, against all the prince of Israel. Terror, including the sword, will be against my people. Therefore, strike your thigh, because it is a testing. And what if the scepter despises even the scepter? The scepter shall be no more. Says the Lord God. You, therefore, son of man, prophesy and strike your hand together the third time. Let the sword do double damage. It is the sword that slays, the sword that slays the great men, that enters their private chambers. I have set the point of the sword against all their gates, that the heart may melt and many may stumble. And it is made bright. It is grass for slaughter. Sword at the ready. Thrust right, set blade. Thrust left, wherever your edge is ordered. I also will beat my fist together, and I will cause my fury to rest. I, the Lord, have spoken. The word of the Lord came to me again, saying, "And son of man, appoint for yourself two ways for the sword of the king of Babylon to go. Both of them shall go from the same land. Make a sign. Put it at the head of the road to the city. Appoint a road for the sword to go to Rabbah of the Ammonites and to Judah, into fortified Jerusalem church. For the king of Babylon stands at the pattern of the road, at the fork of the two roads. To use divination, he shakes the arrows. He consults the images. He looks at the liver. In his right hand is the divination for Jerusalem church, to set up battering rams, to call for a slaughter, to lift the voice with shouting, to set battering rams against the gates, to heap up a siege mound and to build a wall. And it will be to them like a false divination in the eyes of those who have sworn oath with them, but he will bring their iniquity to remembrance, that they may be taken. Therefore, thus says the Lord God, because you have made your iniquity to be remembered, in that your transgressions are uncovered, so that in all your doings your sins appear, because you have come to remembrance, you shall be taken in hand. Now to you, O prophet, wicked prince of Israel, the evil pastors in Nigeria, in Europe, in America, in Asia. Now to you, O prophet, wicked prince of Israel, whose days has come, your days has come. This is your year. Whose days has come, whose iniquity shall end. Thus said the Lord God, remove the turban and take off the crown. Nothing shall remain the same this year. Nothing shall remain the same again. Nothing shall remain the same. Remove the turban and take off the crown. Nothing shall remain the same. Exalt the humble and humble the exalted. Overthrown. I will make it overthrown. It shall be no longer until he comes, whose right it is, and I will give it to him. This year, I want to tell you, because I don't want to waste much of your time. This year, there is going to be so many pastors that will be slaughtered by the Babylonians. Who are the Babylonians? The like in Nigeria, the Hausas, the Fulanis, let me use them, you know, the Muslim people, that their pastor have aligned themselves together, working together with them, doing all manner of evil, because there's no difference between the bloody Muslims, because not all Muslims are bad or wicked. There is no difference between the bloody Muslims, like in Nigeria, that is in politics, that is sucking and drinking the blood of the innocent. There is no difference between them and their pastors and their foolish members. Okay, let me put it like this: that is following them, even when you know that they are not having God's spirit, that they are leading you astray. You are jumping up and down with them. These are the people that you say the righteous is going to be taken. No, Like where I read to you. I read to you right now. He said that. I read something for you now. I read something that talk about the righteous. I think I can get it now. Okay, I read say, and said to the land of Israel, thus says the Lord. Thus says the Lord, behold, I am against you. I will draw my sword out of its sheath and cut off both righteous and the wicked from you. So he's talking about the right, self-righteous people that is claim to be righteous because they claim that their pastor is God. So they are jumped up and down with their pastors, you know. They are cooks for their pastor. To 24 hours they are with him, you know. Even if their pastor say, lick their sweat for them to receive miracle, they will do that. Even if their pastor shits, you know, and then to be to lick the shit, they are ready to do that. They have seen their pastor as God. You will be taken together with your pastor, with your devilish pastor. You claim to be righteous. You fail to understand that our God is a righteous God. That God can never be wicked. Cannot be wicked to tell you to eat grass like an animal. God is so good and so righteous, he cannot tell you to lie down and be marching on top of you. Our God is so righteous that he cannot tell you to drink the oil. They are not oil that they soak their sweat inside the hanky they use, and they soak it inside the oil. I tell you to begin to lick it. That your God is so righteous and so pure, he can't do something. You don't, because you lack common sense, you shall be taken together with your pastor. The Northerners, the Babylonians, they are all over the world. They are always the servant of God. Anytime God wants to bring judgment upon a nation, God will always use Babylonians to carry out his mission. Like in Nigeria, the Hausas. So now, as their pastors, they are jumping up and down, telling you that they are the chosen one. That they will tell you, example, they will tell you, Buhari is the one that God has chosen. That Atiku is the one that God has chosen. So they are preparing daytime. As they are working with them, they know them very, very well. They will come after them this year and cut off their head. There's going to be slaughter. A lot of fake pastors will die this year, especially in Nigeria, all over the world. A lot of fake pastors will die shameful deaths. The Babylonians will deal with them. They will punish them because all that they are doing, they know it. Nothing is hidden. The Northerners knows everything that they are doing. They know that the killings that also they participate in their killing. They participate in the fraud. They are participating in their dirty business, in moving money from Nigeria to other countries, in all the evil that they're doing. They are doing it together. So God have decided to use the Babylonians to cut off the wickedness in the whole universe. There is what's called judgment. Judgment of God, you know, coming upon the church, coming upon James, and Jerusalem means the church, and the false, fake worshippers, people that are worshipping God, you know, in a fake way, lying to themselves, and they know that they're not worshipping God. So there's going to be total destruction, utter destruction upon fake pastors and their followers, and their worshippers, the ones that are worshipping them, because they are not worshipping God. So this is what I want to tell you here. So there will be great slaughter upon evil gatherings called churches, fake worshippers, fake pastors. This is what I just read for you. You can just read it again and hear it very clear and meditate on it. Ezekiel 21 from verse 1 to 27. Ezekiel 21 from verse 1 to 27. You understand what God said. Number two, that God said that it's time for him, that God has turned his back to anything called fake pastor, anything called fake believer. God has turned their back for them to be punished. It's not God punishing them. It's their evil that will eat them up now. Okay, this is number two. So number three, I am taking you now to number three. This is the prophecy for the year 2019. I'm taking you now to John chapter 4. The number three. John chapter 4 verse, John 4, verse 22. Verse 22, I read, You worship what you do not know. We know what we worship, for salvation is of the Jews. But the hour is coming, and now is, when the true worshippers will worship the Father in spirit and truth, in spirit and truth. For the Father is seeking such to worship him. God is spirit. God is spirit. And those who worship him must worship in spirit and truth. So this year, the true worshippers that know that God is not living in a building molded by man. Our God is so powerful, so big. God doesn't live in a house built by man. God lives in human being. So this year, if you don't have God inside of you, if you are not worshiping God from the inside of you, if you are a fake worshiper that is worshiping God, nothing for you. Nothing for you. It's time for people that is worshiping that's worshiping in the building, that turned the building to be a place of their worship. It's of them to know that God is spirit, that those that must worship God in that they are the church, that this God is in them, that they are the church. You are the church, not the building. So it's time for the true worshipers to really be in power, serving God, enjoying the best. And the people that is going to the mountain, going to the building, deceiving themselves, thinking that they're worshiping God, this is time for them to be exposed because of what will happen to them. This year, the true worshippers that is worshiping God in the inside of them will be revealed. That knows that if I go to any church and I don't see God's spirit, I quit. If I see any pastor and I look at his lifestyle, I see what he's doing, that he's not really worshiping God, he's not serving God, he doesn't have God's spirit, I will quit. If you are busy jumping from one mountain to another, there's calamity. Because calamity that we hit that structure, that we hit that thing called church this year is great. It's time for the true worshippers to be revealed. God will introduce you. If you are worshiping him in the inside of you, if you are worshiping God, that if you know that you are the temple of God, that God lives in you, this year, you will end up this year in highest glory, rejoicing at the latter. And you will look at what is happening to the fake worshippers. You will say, God, I thank you for this wonderful revelation, for letting me know that you are not a God that lives in a building molded by man. You're not a God that lives on a mountain, but you're a God that lives in us. He said that we are the house of God. We are the temple of the living God. So, if you don't have God inside of you, going to church is useless. If you are going to a place where they are doing other ceremonial rituals and cuisines and all that, then God is not there. This year, what will be happening on the structure, this thing called the molded, is going to be something else. Because God have totally removed himself totally from this rubbish, all this nonsense that they're doing. You know, that they're using his name to do, that the people are using his name in the gathering people in the building, telling that God is here. This year God will reveal himself. God will reveal the people that he is in their life. He will reveal to the people. He will reveal himself to his own people, to his own true worshippers. Why the fake worshippers? We also know that what they are doing, that God sees it. Alright, so this year, as I said to you, the place of time to know true worshippers. This year, number three, is time to know true worshippers, not church or mountain visitors. Time to know the true worshippers, not church goers or mountain visitors. Visiting mountain, thinking that they are serving God. No, it's not. God is in human being. We are the house of God. We are the temple of the living God. So this year, prophecy number three, time to know true worshippers, not church or mountain visitors. John chapter 4, 22 to 24. John 4, 22 to 24. Okay, number four, prophecy of the year. It's taken from the book of 1 Peter. Number four. Prophecy of the year. Number four, I want to read to you. Number four is taken from the book of 1 Peter chapter 2 from verse 4. Number four, prophecy of the year is taken from the book of 1 Peter chapter 2 from verse 4 to 9. It said, coming to him as to a living stone, rejected indeed by men, but chosen by God and precious. You also, as living stone, are being built up a spiritual house. I say to you that you are the house of God, you are the church. I said it earlier. He said, coming to him as to a living stone, rejected indeed by men, but chosen by God and precious. You also, as living stones, are being built up a spiritual house, a holy priesthood, to offer up spiritual sacrifices acceptable to God through Jesus Christ. Therefore, it is also contained in the scripture, behold, I lay in Zion a chief cornerstone, elect, precious, and he who believes on him will by no means be put to shame. Therefore, to those who believe, he is precious, but to those who are disobedient, the stone which the builders rejected has become the chief cornerstone and a stone of stumbling and a rock of offense. They stumble, being disobedient to the word of God, to the word to which they also were appointed. They are jumping at the love of God, but they are disobedient to God's word. They hate God's word. What we are seeing today, many pastors, they don't want to, they are not doing anything. All that they are doing is whatever thing they want to do, not what is in the word of God, or what the word of God said. But though they carry the word of God, they carry the Bible. It's not what the Bible says, it's what they are doing. So they stumble, being disobedient to the word to which they also were appointed. But you are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, his own special people, that you may proclaim the praises of him who called you out of darkness into his marvelous light. And God, this year, God will be introducing to the whole world his own priests, his own pastors, his own preachers. God will be introducing his own true preachers, the one that he called, that he ordained. The one that he molded himself in them, his true church. God will introduce you to the whole world in glory, in honor, in power, in praise. The whole world will stand in unison and they will give praise to God. They will praise God. They will give God praise for what God will do in the life of his anointed ones, the one that he has chosen. The whole world in unison will give him, will clap hands for him. They will see you and they say, praise God. They will see the true man of God and say, praise God. It's time for all this ritualistic, all this occultic men and women that is praying themselves as men of God and women of God. They are devil. That is devil incarnates. Bloody sucking, lying vessels moving on earth, causing damage. It's time for shame and disgrace to submit. It's time for shame and disgrace to fill them. And it's time for the whole world to see the true man of God and say, speak to us. We want to hear you. They will bless you. They will hold you. They will say, praise God. They will say, praise God. Finally, God is glorified. God is still God. Let all men be lying. Those men that is lying with his name, all of them are, oh, they are already marked criminals, liars. But our God forever is glorified. He is God. He is a righteous God forever. So only him, the whole world will stand in awe of him and they will say, praise God once again. They will praise him in the beauty of his holiness. This is what I want to tell you. Number four, I just give you now. God introducing his own priests, his own pastors, his own men and women of God in glory, in honor, in praise to his name. Okay, no, number five. Finally, number five, I want to give to you. I say to you, this year is a great year. Just don't hear this alone. Meditate on it. Take your Bible and read, and you understand more of what I'm doing. What is, you know, you understand the year more, what the year brings in, what the year want to offer, what the year want to give to everybody, so you can understand it very clear as you meditate on this prophecy. Don't mind anymore. All these people talking, anything they want to talk, they are just empty barrier. What God said will stand. Let us see. If this I'm telling you is from God, let us see. Let us watch and see what happens. I'm reading now number five, prophecy of the year is taken from the book of James. The book of James chapter 1, verse 9. Let the lowly brother glory in his exaltation. Let the lowly brother glory in his exaltation. But the rich in his humiliation. Because as a flower of the field, he will pass away. This year, God will be exalting his right, his righteous one, the one that is that humble themselves and wait for him, that are waiting for him to lift them up. Though all the children of God, all over the world, in Germany, in Europe, in Africa, in America, in Asia, all the true believers in Christ, all the true children of God that humble themselves, that bring themselves down before him and cry in day and night, expecting him to do something, this year you'll be exalted. God will exalt you this year to inherit the land. God is out. God is already, is already exalted. He's out to exalt the humble ones, those that humble themselves before our God. The humble one in Christ, the humble in Christ that brings himself down. We understand, Jesus did not exalt himself. When he died, he waited for his Father to exalt him, to lift him up. And Bible says he humbled himself and died, even the death of the cross. Therefore, God highly exalted him. He did not exalt himself. All the self-exalted ones will fall down this year. All the self-exalted ones will be dragged down to the pit of hell. We'll be dragged down to nothing. We'll be brought to nothing. Humiliation. What we'll be seeing is humiliation upon all the fake preachers, fake believers that exalted themselves by going to get power from demonic source to be calling Jesus. And all the self-exalted ones of the whole world will fall down to the pit of hell. Those that bring themselves down, that bring themselves low, will be exalted. Bible says that humility goes before honor. Why pride goes before downfall? So those that bring themselves down, waiting for God all these years, this year is your year of exaltation. God is in the business of exalting his own children, and also in the business of washing down every devil and demon. The devil exalted himself above God, and he was forced down. All the people that is serving devil, because devil is cast down once again, all of them that is agent of devil will be cast down together with their master, the devil. And all of you that is in Christ Jesus will be exalted together, all of us together with Christ, will be exalted in the highest, will be exalted to the highest level, doing great and wonderful things for our master Jesus forever. God bless you. This is the prophecy of the year, and I have given it to you the way it is. God bless you. Very good. And see you as you hear this. Write it down and try to let other people hear it. If you are a church goer, be careful. This year is dangerous. Jump up and down with pastors on your own, because God has said it. It's happening already. The earth of calamity is coming upon the church. Because church have caused the whole world damage. They have bring the whole world down. The church have caused the whole world to be smelled. Fake churches. Yet God is out now to do it. God bless you. God bless you. I want you to remember, I pray that not evil will come near you, nor come near your family members. You have heard it. No grave trouble. No grave trouble will attack the righteous. No grave trouble. The year 2019, the year of God's goodness. Remember this.